Zero can be a weird number. Doing arithmetic with zero can lead to unusual results. Adding or subtracting zero from a quantity does absolutely nothing. Multiplying any number by zero will always crush it down to a value of zero. And division by zero isn't even possible. Let's venture further into the unusual world of zero and see how it works with exponents. We saw that we can describe repeating multiplication with an exponent. Multiplying 3 by itself 4 times can be written with an exponent as 3 to the 4th power. But what if we had an exponent 3 to the power of 0? Looking at the symbols, it may not be apparent what that even means. What is 3 times itself 0 times? Remember, this isn't 3 times 0, so 3 to the power of 0 doesn't equal 0. Let's go back to our folded paper and figure this out. We'll start with our paper folded into thirds, 2 times. With 2 folds, this could be described as 3 to the 2nd power. If we unfold one stage, the page has only one triple fold. This would be 3 to the 1st power. If we undo the last stage of folding, we have no longer tripled the page. There is no longer a times 3 being performed on the paper. This would be 3 to the power of 0. If we look at the thickness of the page, it is just one page thick. 3 to the power of 0 is 1. In fact, any base number to the power of 0 will be 1. Looking at our single page, we could be planning on folding it into a crazy accordion fold that gives it a thickness of 20. That fold would multiply the thickness by 20, which would be 20 to the power of 1. Before we make that fold, though, it hasn't been multiplied. It has a thickness of 1 and could be described as 20 to the power of 0. No matter the size or complexity of a number, when it is given an exponent of 0, it becomes a value of 1. Before you think this is a trick based on the paper model and is just a sleight of hand, let's see how the exponent of 0 fits into a larger pattern. Moving down the number line, we've seen exponents of 3, 2, 1, and on down to 0. Let's keep going and see what we'd get with negative exponents. We know that 2 to the power of 1 is 2, meaning that we've doubled our paper thickness 1 time. But what's 2 to the power of negative 1? Quick hint, it's not negative 2. In general, when you swap in a negative value in a math statement, it indicates we're doing the opposite of something. Arithmetic operations have opposites. The opposite of addition is subtraction. The opposite of multiplication is division. Exponents describe repeated multiplication. With a negative exponent, we're repeating the opposite of multiplication, which is division. What's the opposite of doubling the thickness of a piece of paper? Slicing it in half. Slicing the paper in half makes it one half as thick, which we could describe as 2 to the power of negative 1. Slicing one of these half-thick pieces again gives us a piece that's 1/4 of a page thick, which could be described as 2 to the power of negative 2. We repeatedly multiply by 2 with a positive exponent, and we repeatedly divide by 2 when we have a negative exponent. The exponent of 2 to the power of 4 is a more efficient way to say multiplying by 2 4 times. The exponent of 2 to the power of negative 4 is a more efficient way to say dividing by 2 4 times. We can see how the pattern flips from the positive to the negative side of the number line. On the positive side, 2 to the power of 1 is 2, to the power of 2 is 4, and to the power of 3 is 8. with negative exponents, 2 to the power of negative 1 means we divide by 2 once, which gives us 1 half. 2 to the power of negative 2 means we divide by 2 twice, which is 1 fourth. And 2 to the power of negative 3, we divide by 2 once more and get 1 eighth. Essentially, the value of a number with a positive exponent gets swapped into a fraction under the value of 1 if it switches to a negative exponent. The negative exponent values gives us the reciprocals of the positive exponent values, meaning it becomes a fraction under 1. 2 to the power of 4 is 16, while 2 to the power of negative 4 is 1/16. Let's take a look at how the numbers evolve as we move further along in either direction of the number line. As we get bigger and bigger exponents, the values we're describing are very quickly expanding. 8 to 16, 32, 64, 128, and so on. The values are never going to stop growing and are heading towards infinity, although of course they can never really get there. In the other direction, we're describing fractions that are getting smaller and smaller, 1/8, 1/16, 1/32, and so on. These values are getting smaller and smaller and are heading towards a value of 0, but although they will get painfully close, they can never make it to 0. So right there, serving as a sort of pivot between values climbing towards infinity and values shrinking towards nothingness, is the exponent of 0, which makes everything a value of 1.